In this next interview, I had the pleasure of chatting with the awesome Aisha Raza, a seasoned actress whose shiny repertoire of film credits and performances set her apart as a bankable artist. Aisha is also a successful voiceover artist, the skills for which she inherited through a family lineage of accomplished radio broadcasters. Having been a part of hit films such as Sonu Ki Deetu Ki Sweetie, Dil Dhadakne Do, Love Per Square Foot and shows like Made in Heaven, Aisha has cemented her place in Bollywood. She has also acted in short films such as Khane Mein Kya Hai, Chimes and more. You can follow Aisha on her Insta channel and catch the links to her movies and other shows in the description of this interview. Now sit back, grab a drink and watch this interview. And if you enjoy it, please like, share and subscribe to this channel. Hello and welcome to What's Up with Vasant. I have the lovely Aisha Raza joining me on this interview. How are you doing, Aisha?
I'm doing okay, yeah. The best we possibly can in these circumstances. Nothing is really good right now.
Yeah, that's true.
Okay, touch wood. Not complaining about my particular state. I'm very blessed, lucky. But given the circumstance right now in the country, all over the world,
True. Yeah,
the best we possibly can.
And can you tell us about where you were born, where you were
raised? I was born oddly in a small little place called Muscat. Muscat is the little unknown city near Dubai. It's in the country called Sultanate of Oman.
Acha.
So I was born there and my dad was, parents were there for about 35 years.
Oh,
so half my studies were in Muscat and half of them were in boarding school in Ooty. So I'm a true Tamilian, South Indian girl at heart.
Acha. And then from there to Ooty, that must have been quite a transition.
Yeah. It was, but I thought that my mom thought that I was getting spoiled as a little Gulf child. Okay, Mercedes ne ghumna hai aur five stars ne jaana hai. I don't think I was that spoiled, but my mom was very like particular. Okay, nahi, ye sab nahi ho sakta.
Achha.
So boarding school. But she sent me to an amazing school, very cool, very easy, very different, alternative education. Tha.
Did you happen to learn any Arabic in the time that you were there?
No, very, very sadly, no.
Khalas. Just khalas and...
Khalas, kefalet, zen, alhamdulillah. Yeah.
Shukran. Yeah, right.
Shukran.
Cool. And so I was also trying to research you online and I found that you have links to the film industry. You are related to people from the industry. Would that be fair to say?
Industry to nahi. My grand aunt was Zohra Sehgal. And their younger sister was Uzra Bhatt, and they were both actresses with Prithvi Theatres, with Prithvi Raj Kapoor. And so they started their acting journey, of course, in that time, pioneering, coming from a Parda family, you know, in the 1930s, to break away and to join dance and to join theatre was a very big thing. So they sort of laid the foundations and carved the path for us to sort of follow without any problem. My mom was also a theater actor. I mean, she never did film, but she was always very active in theater. And so, yeah, it's been in the family, I would say. But we're not filmy like that.
Got it. Yeah. And you moved back to India. And then at what point in time or where did the actual journey begin? Like, was it movies
Theater. I came back from the US. I did a small theater course in Delhi. And as I was doing the theater course, somebody was making a TV show there. They said, Karugi. So I was like, haan, karte hain. Itna milega. It was quite good for those days. It was still 1,000 rupees a day. So it was still pretty good.
Yeah.
That made me realize ke I'm okay. I can manage in front of camera. Kar sakti hu. And then after about a year, people said, if you really want to pursue acting, then Bombay chalna hoga, Delhi mein kuch nahi hone wala tumhara. So I sort of made the move. I said, haan, chalo, chalte hain.
Okay. And so then when you moved to Bombay, did you have any contacts? What was that journey like? Because a lot of people talk about their struggle and stuff. So did you have that kind of a struggle?
I never had the struggle. I think mainly because I always had a very realistic perspective of my look, like God-given cheeks and bulai, which I have this round cheek. So I never fit into the, even at 24, 25, I never fit into the lead actress category, whether television, whether film.
Okay.
So I don't think I ever came with that intention to become a star. I just came to act. And I came that I have to earn my living. That was primary for me.
Sure.
So I कोई एक कोई थे जो मुझे मिले थे जो साउंड इंजीनियर थे कोई कैमरामैन थे दे सेड टू मी आउट व्हेन यू कम व्हाई डोंट यू कम एंड मीट अस एंड वन ऑफ द साउंड इंजीनियर्स आई न्यू ही आई कॉल्ड हिम अप आई सेड सी अनिल सर आई एम हियर एंड ही सेड अच्छा कहां पे हो आई सेड आई एम इन अंधेरी एंड ही सेड डू यू नो वेयर मड आइलैंड इज एंड आई सेड आई हैव नो आइडिया एंड ही सेड चलो चलो कम So I didn't know where it was. I called up a friend. He said, "Oh, not nothing. You take a rickshaw, you go to Versova Beach, and then you take a boat, and then you cross over on that boat, and then you take right, another." Right. I said, "Where am I going?" But I did all this boat business. I landed up at a set where somebody was shooting a boat stories for Doordarshan at the time.
Okay.
And those somebody's were Tigmanshu Dhulia and Irfan Khan.
Wow.
Because at that time Irfan sir was not in. Sort of his time hadn't come in terms of becoming
sure.
a real big
yeah, yeah.
So this was all his sort of like kuch karna hai to you know ye Doordarshan ke liye direct kar do unhone. So he came up to me, looked at me like this, said that. He said ye role hai, koi neighbor wali, some there's a neighboring auntie or something, and karogi. I said, huh, I'll give you 1,000 rupees a day, same price that I was getting. I was very excited.
Wow. Right, right.
So that was an amazing experience. And post which, I think I did a lot of voiceovers. So I've done a lot of voice work for ads, for documentaries, films.
Sure.
Kept that going.
So aap voiceover ke baat kar rahe ho. So how does one, what kind of skills must one have to become a voiceover artist?
I think it came from my mom because, again, family of broadcasters. My dadi was the first woman broadcaster for BBC Urdu Service or BBC. She's in the records. So she was one of those. My mom was a broadcaster for All India Radio and then Radio Oman for the donkey's years. So everybody's been in this line. I think at the time of my grandmom and mom, it was more about having a pleasing voice, your diction, your pronunciation, and you know, what are you trying to communicate through your voice? How are you going to communicate it? So we were taught, I was taught in a very old-fashioned way. And then when you come, you realize that, no, your market is not 80-year-olds. You know, it's 25-year-olds. And right. you have to talk in a more colloquial fashion or, you know, you don't have to have this very soothing, you know,
sure.
way of yeah. talking. As long as if you're selling a product, then you yeah. have to talk like what people want to hear. So right, both right. changes karne pade mujhe dheere dheere.
Yeah. That's very interesting.
I have to adjust.
Yeah. And so then you went into movies. Yeah. You got your acting job.
Oh no, I did television for a while. I did a television for a year. Where I at 26 was also straight cast into Buaji. Straight.
Achha.
Like so I kind of was not enjoying it. And I didn't enjoy television because the acting was not challenging. It was rather one note. But I did it because it was sustaining me at the time.
Sure.
And then I decided, nahin, I'll leave TV, I'll take up voicing for my money, and I will do theater for my acting. So I think a good 6 or 7 years, I just did my theater. And voicing was what sustained me financially.
Got
and it was because I didn't have to worry about theater maybe or voicing maybe. I didn't have to worry about my look.
Right.
You know, your cheeks are too round and your eyes are... So it was a good time. Movies happened for a good 7 years.
I don't know if... I mean... Obviously, there is this sort of preferential treatment that is given to people that look a certain way in the industry. You always want to look cosmetically perfect. And it's this, you know, assembly line product type actors and actresses that you get. But there were also a slew of actors and actresses that made it in the movies, you know, where they played. Basically, they got roles in independent cinema or more parallelish cinema, right?
Yeah.
So, is that not something that you were interested in?
So at the time, it was very divided. When I grew up in the 80s, it was commercial cinema was Jitendra, Himamalini, Sridevi. The 80s cinema, no? Himmat Wala.
Oh,
and
sure.
That. And then parallelly, there was Govind Nirani, Nasiruddin Shaum, Puri Shabana Azmi, Smita Patel.
Right, right.
So that's what we knew, that, if you want to go and have a commercial entertainer, then this is this. And if you want to watch solid acting and performance, then this is pretty much
the Ketan Mehtas and so on and so forth.
Yeah, it was a complete divide in those days. In my time, I had come at a time where television soap operas were the thing. They had just come up in a big way. So the performance, acting, none of it was important. It was just like Bold and the Beautiful format just been applied a few years ago to India. So people were, you know, enjoying that whole glamour. You have to look the part and you have to just stand there and the camera will do pretty much all the joking and the
got it. Yeah, I understood.
For yeah. you have so that time was very different. Then it started changing very slowly, where the character actors started becoming important in films. Then people like me were said, yeah, if you want someone who looks the part, she looks the part. She doesn't necessarily have to be gorgeous. But yeah, if I say ki ye meri Punjabi bua hai, then she looks sure. like my Punjabi. So Go thereby, ahead. It changed for a lot of us.
Right, right. So there was something for everyone then along the way, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So when you made your foray back into films, what was the first film that you did?
First film that I had done, and then uske baad, the first film that which means a lot to me and which helped me was Dil Dhadakne Do, which was Zoya Akhtar's
sure.
film.
Yeah.
The one on the cruise ship.
Yeah, yeah.
But so it was absolutely the most incredible experience of my entire life. I don't think waisa kuch hoga. Because of who Zoya is as a person and as a director. And the performances that she gets out of you, the way she deals with you, the importance that she will give even to the most minute characters, the respect with which you are treated on a set full of stars. I mean, we were a bunch of 25 actors and we had everybody. We had Farhan Akhtar, we had Priyanka Chopra, we had Ranveer Singh, we had Anushka Sharma, we had Anil Kapoor, we had Shefali Shah, we had a bunch of really top-notch people and we were new.
Right.
So we didn't feel that people would even be looking in our direction, you know.
Sure.
But that's why that film was special, because every single actor, Zoya, sort of, she holds you in her hand and she treats you with the same love and respect that she would treat
the rest of the cast. Yeah.
Yeah. So that's why that film is very, very special.
Okay. And then you do, you know, you went along the way, you did a lot of other movies like Student of the Year 2, Veeray the Wedding, Toilet, Ek Love Story, Befikre, and so on and so forth. Yeah. So along the way, you know, you obviously started getting certain kinds of roles. Is that something that, you know, you would look at, and I'm sure you must have thought about it some point in time, that there's a dearth of roles for women, not just you as an actress, but in general, across the spectrum, a lot of actresses, when they pass a certain age, they start getting offered all these, you know, roles that are that are sometimes even beyond their own generation.
Correct.
So
yeah, we're all playing 10 years older than we are.
Yeah.
We're all being 10 years older than we are. But that's the case with women, right?
Yeah.
Wahida Rehman, or you know, in a film she can be Amitabh. In one film she's his heroine, and the other film she's his mother. Like in the span of a few years.
It's just ridiculous.
Older, and suddenly you see that the heroes are 45 and the heroines are 16.
They just keep getting younger.
Yeah, and then the moment the woman passes 35, she's straight into auntie.
Yeah, it's very strange.
So that's just in the industry. We don't want to see our women older. We want to see the young women.
Yeah. I see what you mean. And so, what do you do as an actress to hone your own skill? How do you manage to keep...
I don't think I'm that active as... I mean, I have to admit I'm pretty lazy. But no, I think I live with... I married the right man. So observing him is honing skills. Okay. I think it's by default that I married such a wonderful actor who's so committed and so sincere with his craft, be it theater or film, that I think everything that I don't do, he does like 800 times more. And I constantly have to look at him and say, oh God, what is this? You know? Yeah.
I mean, obviously to have under the same roof, two people who are such brilliant actors, you and she was referring to the legendary Mr. Kumud Mishra, that's her husband. So you guys must share a lot of notes, right? Having been in the business for such a long
time. They're very critical of each other. He doesn't mince any words. If he doesn't like something, he will come up and tell me, ke bilkul achha nahi tha. I, on the other hand, if I don't like something he's done, I won't watch it. So there are films of his which I've just not seen. And I'm like, no, I'm not feeling it. I don't want to see that movie. So he'll be like, achha, theek hai. So it's a bit like that.
What about your influences? Were there books along the way that you read that sort of helped you get into this line of work? Or movies?
I think acting influences were mainly, as I said, that genre of parallel cinema, which my mother really encouraged me to watch. So Shabana Azmi being, I swear, in my till date, I've not seen an Indian actor that level. I cannot imagine anybody being, this is my personal opinion, of course, it's my fan moment. But she is absolutely amazing. And watched a lot of Pakistani television in the 80s, which was brilliant writing, brilliant performances, very natural, very spontaneous. So I think my acting performances are more inspired from Tanhaiya and Kahini, Dhoop Ke Naare, that whole lot of Pakistani television
shows
of the 80s.
So basically that was a big source of inspiration for you, were the Pakistani dramas. And then you did some short films along the way, and in the form of Ek Bahut Choti Si Love Story, Chimes, Khane Mein Kya Hai, Dekhne Mein Kya Harj Hai. And I loved all of them. I must admit, I spent some time watching them. I enjoyed them all. Ek Bahut Choti Si Love Story was a very twisted ending. Because I was quite fascinated by the 6 minutes where the guy is trying to make conversation with you and you're acting a little distant, and then the ending is just so
it's really warped. I have a great story when it comes to that show. I remember it was a small film, so hum log sab, we were using our own props, like our own bags and all. So they'd given me the prop gun. So I remember I had to run after shoot. I had work, and I said chalo, I'm going, and I was carrying my own bag and I was using it in the shoot, and that gun sort of, I just dumped it and I ran. The next day, I had to take my husband's sister for some treatment to Dadar. Dadar is the center of the Shiv Sena offices and things like that.
Oh, it's God. Like,
so, all that being fine, I ended up in a cafe. And so, this is really funny. And I'm sitting with my sister-in-law waiting for the doctor's office to open. And I sort of glance into my bag and I see a gun. So, I'm thinking, Okay. So, being a Muslim and around a very, you know, this kind of place, I was like, oh dear God. And then my husband, in the meanwhile, is shooting in Rajasthan for this brilliant film. Actually, you should watch it. It's called Filmistan. He is playing a Pakistani terrorist in the film. That's and amazing. He's grown out his beard and he's got that pagri and that Pakistani thing and kajal, and he's sending me pictures from the shoot. So I noticed this gun, then I'm looking at this picture and I'm saying, you know, hiding my phone, and I'm saying, even if I say, nay, I married this Hindu Brahmin, you know, I'm
No,
look at, this is my husband. It was a filmy moment. I'm like, could everything go wrong for me? At, you know, my location, then the gun.
Okay, cool. So then Chimes. Okay.
Yeah.
Chimes is a very beautiful story. You got to play these two different characters in it. The ending was kind of a question mark, and I was curious to know. That's why I think it's a brilliant time to ask you. Does this mean the kid shot the father at the end?
I honestly have seen it. Main bhi nahi samjhi thi.
Okay. So then it is up for interpretation then.
Yeah.
Okay. Khane Mein Kya Hai was a very interesting, poignant film. I think that it speaks about something that a lot of people in Indian society like to ignore, and it's something that touches upon women across the country because they can't speak about it, especially women from the previous generations cannot speak about feeling unfulfilled in the act of love. So was that something that, what was it about this story? Because I think that's a very heavy subject for you that you wanted to be a part of this film.
It was, I think, Akanksha, who's our director, and Shikha Talsani, she's also a friend. And I think when she sent us the script, there was a bit like, kya hoga? But I think that she handled it so well, and it was written so well, that also because Shikha and I are friends, and we had a good, you know, understanding between each other. So, wo ho gaya, but I think it was...
You know, I'm just interested, is this something that you, as an actress, also try to do? Because in your movies, you typically got... you know, certain kinds of roles, and now that you're getting to experiment in short films or on OTT platforms, you can do things that are a little more risque, if I may call it that. Not even risque in the literal sense, but it's pushing the envelope from your usual type of stuff that you did. So is that something that you look for as an actress?
I think one is always looking for a change in the character or a slightly different interpretation of something. I think we are still unfortunately slotted by look. It really defines what work you get. So because I think it's very basic. Like the audience looks at you and they say, "Huh, this is correct. Ye aise lagti hai. Meri mummy bhi aise lagti hai. Meri chachi aise lagti hai." So they identify with you. which is why someone like Alok Nath could play Papa for like some 800 years. Kumud is very particular about his look. Like, he doesn't want to be this sort of similar. He will always try and, if you see a collage of his pictures from all his films, he looks completely different.
Right.
In each film. Women don't have, ke mooch lagalo, ye karlo, you know, I
understand come up with, what you mean. Yeah.
I came up with ideas. I said, you know, why don't you think, you know how you have some people have thicker eyebrows or something like a unibrow or something. I've always tried to do something with my look, like saying, ke, you know, there are women who look like this also. But a lot of directors are not interested. They're like, nahi bhaiya, jo jaise hai, usko rehne do. To me, like, people like Vidya Balan or Shef Ali Shah, people who are really getting to carry out really meaty roles for women. Mm. As heroines, I would say Kangana has been one who's been getting some good work, or she's been choosing good work, or whatever.
Sure. Tabu would be a good example.
Tabu's amazing. Yeah, Tabu is somebody.
Brilliant.
Absolutely
brilliant.
There is no question.
Yeah. I'm a huge fan of Tabu as well. So, talking about, and it's quite crazy because you mentioned your look quite a few times in this interview. It's sad because I look at you and I find you to be extremely charming and lovely. And I think that the definition of good looking as a perception that filmmakers are feeding into the audience's mind is what is causing this.
But social perceptions, I think America is definitely coming out of it. Like, if you watch a reality show called America's Next Top Model, I think they... Yeah. Continually try to get a variety of shapes, sizes, colors, races. So exactly. I think they really try to, in their own way, break the idea of what a model is. It's not always thin with jawline, with blonde hair or blue eye, whatever the concept is. So they've tried. And I think that slowly, it should follow suit. But it's they're still in India stuck with ladki gori hair, she's this, she's that. It's still pretty, it's pretty difficult for girls today.
I saw on your Instagram post, this cover picture of Judi Dench, right?
Yes. And
I think that's a perfect example of that.
Yeah.
I've been following Nina Gupta ji ever since there's been a resurgence in her career for the last few years. I've been following her work very closely. I have a huge crush on her. I think she looks gorgeous. She's a beautiful lady. And I think the people at large find her gorgeous. Like, people at large would find her attractive.
But she was always very... She's just prettier because I think when women learn to... And I think this is something I've been telling myself as well, that regardless of whether I'll have days where I'm not feeling confident, or where I'm going to compare myself to somebody maybe prettier or thinner or whatever the conventional...
Yeah.
But I think once you get into your skin, once you are comfortable... there's no... I mean, look at Queen Latifah, for example. I mean, she's amazing. Just look at her confidence. Look at the clothes she carries. Look at the way she'll carry herself on the set.
Right.
That's the ideal. The ideal is that be who you are. Don't be complex by anything. But I'm saying in India, a woman who's dark and who's overweight would never be considered a style icon. Yeah, she could never be considered a style icon.
Out of the new crop of filmmakers, and I say new now, but they've been around for about 10-15 years. I'm talking about the Vishal Bharadwajes, Imtiaz Aliz, Anurag Kashyaps, and so on and so forth. Is there, and we've just talked about Zoya Akhtar herself, are there any particular directors that interest you that you would like to work with, whose works that you really like?
I think for a long time, Imtiaz was somebody I'm interested in because he's done some great work with performance. So I think for the last few films, I think it's been unfortunate because every filmmaker goes through, you know, actors go through a creative high, creative low. So that I couldn't judge him by his last few movies. But other than that, he has a very good grip on performance sense. And so I would be interested to be directed by him. I would be very interested to be directed by Zoya in anything he does. So for me, I feel that she's very important. As Vishal Bharadwaj, I would be very interested to work with.
Got it.
Anurag sir, obviously, he's done some amazing work. If there's something that comes up for me, of course, I'd be very interested.
You know, I always hear actors talk about how directors can get performances out of actors. A primary example of that would be, and I use this example, I'm not saying there aren't other actors, but Saif Ali Khan in as Langda Tyagi in Omkara, right?
Omkara.
Someone who's otherwise so sophisticated and urban, and then getting to do something that's so rooted and rural and raw. So then how does a director get this performance? Like, for our audiences to understand, what does it mean to be able to get a performance?
So, there was a time, so I'll just use Dil Dhadakne Do as an example.
Right.
You're playing a small character. वैसे तो देखो तो इट्स नॉट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू द फिल्म. आई एम नॉट, यू नो, वी आर नॉट ह्यूजली बिग की प्लेयर्स. बट व्हेन अ डायरेक्टर वांट्स समथिंग फ्रॉम यू, दे हैव अ वे ऑफ कमिंग टू यू एंड सेइंग, सुनो ये नहीं, यू नो, इसको ऐसे कर दो, उसको वैसे कर दो, बात नहीं बन रही. इफ यू कांट डू इट, दे विल कम एंड गिव यू एग्जांपल. दे विल ट्राई एंड इंस्पायर यू फ्रॉम योर ओन लाइफ एक्सपीरियंसेस. सो आई रिमेंबर फॉर वन पर्टिकुलर लाइन, ज़ोया मेड मी डू, वेरी स्मॉल लाइन, इट वाज़न्ट एनीथिंग ड्रामेटिक, शी सेड, I ended up doing 17 takes for that one line. And that's what I'm saying. It was important to her that even the smallest character gets the line the way she has. And she's very open to, yeah, and she's very open to interpret. Like, she's very open to suggestions. So if I walk in and I say, you know, Zoya, I've read this, I feel I should do this. She's like, okay, so now, tell me.
Achha.
So I would tell her and she would say, yeah, I like it. Do it in the shop. Show me. If I like it, we'll keep it.
Okay, we'll move on to something else lighter now. Who are your favorite co-stars from all these years that you've been acting?
So Manoj Pawar, I've done a lot of films with him.
Right.
He's another one, I've just worked with him. He's also my neighbor. Yeah. So Pankaj is someone I've recently, the film is going to come out on Netflix. It's called The Kargil Girl.
Heard about that.
So that's next whatever release, so to speak. But it was he I look up to a lot, and he's amazing to work. And Shiva, as a girl, I have too much fun with her.
Like Shiva Chadda.
I love working with her. We can have fun, and she's so spirited on set. We've done 2 projects together, and theater also. We know each other from. So it's really fun to work.
Yeah. Watch her interview on WhatsApp with Basanta. I've already done her interview last. It's going to be coming out soon. So do check it out. We're right at the end. Do you have any special message for your fans about any new projects that you want? You absolutely have fans.
So sweet. The only message of ye kehna hai, toh, I'm saying just be kind. Be good to people. You know, this lockdown, if nothing else, should teach us the responsibility and the you know, that to love our loved ones, to be kind. Yeah. You know, don't use this time in the lockdown behind your computer to be hateful. That's all I feel. And I can see so much hate in this world where there's so much crisis already. And then we're doubling it up by just being hateful. So I just feel like just relax, be kind and appreciate, you know, every single minute of every single day. That's all. That's the only thing I would say.
Well, it's been such a pleasure interviewing you. Thank you so much for giving me the time. And I really appreciate it. And do you have any shout outs to give for any upcoming projects that you would like to do through this channel?
So Netflix is a lovely small film with Gunjan called Gunjan Saxena, the Kargil Girl with Jhanvi Kapoor.
Cool.
And with working with her, I can tell you she is the one to look out for. She's going to be amazing in this film. She is really going to be amazing. And my director, Sharan Sharma, who is one of the sweetest boys there is. So, yeah.
Cool. We'll definitely catch it. Anything else? Any other projects lined up?
There's this crazy wacko comedy I've done called Lakshmi Bomb. With
Awesome. Akshay Kumar. Yeah, that's coming out.
So that should come up at some point.
Okay. Awesome. Thank you so much. Thank you.